LA, home of the movies, heart of celebrity culture. It's where the rich and famous rise and fall. And when they fall, it's where they go to rehab. They're frequently snapped going in and out, but what goes on behind closed doors? Seven high-profile addicts have agreed to be followed through this intensely personal.
I've got to stop crying today. I think I just need to sleep.
Occasionally joyful.
I'm seeing a better way to deal with it now.
And often excruciating process.
Everyone's got a past, and I want my past kept in the past.
Passages isn't a conventional rehab clinic. Instead of concentrating on the substances its clients are addicted to, it focuses on why they are addicted.
Alcoholism and addiction are not diseases. They're just symptoms. Alcohol and drugs actually have nothing to do with it.
Using a broad spectrum of therapies, their unique approach combines the conventional with the alternative. Believing recovery should sometimes be fun.
We did it!
It's exclusive, it's luxurious, and it'll be home to seven new clients for the next 2 weeks. Bay City roller Les McEwen is here to stop more than 25 years of alcoholism.
Hi, welcome to Passages.
Kiss and Tell girl Alicia Duval has an obsession with plastic surgery. And glamour model Cassie Sumner is battling bulimia. Robin LeMessurier, rock and roller son of John LeMessurier and Hattie Jakes, is struggling with the demon drink. Victoria Sellers, daughter of Peter Sellers and Britt Eklund, is here to end years of drug abuse. Karate Kid star Sean Kanan is trying to overcome an addiction to painkillers. And this is the story of X Factor finalist Rowetta as she tries to overcome her addiction to alcohol.
A mocha chocolata, yeah, yeah. Creole lady, mama, love. You don't want to hear the voulez-vous.
Rowetta's career reached its height as the backing singer with the Happy Mondays. A band known as much for their drink and drug use as for their music.
I've had loads of highs. I think I've been really, really lucky. Sung with some brilliant people. I've sang at Wembley Stadium, supporting Oasis. We've been on Top of the Pops. I think I've done it 5 times with Happy Mondays. Sang on the big stage at Children in Need. I have done great things.
But the rock and roll lifestyle came at a price. Years of alcohol abuse and a dread of the public spotlight.
I'm not a TV personality, purposely, really. I'm a singer. When I'm singing, I'm confident.
Gives all of her time.
When I've got to talk to strangers and I need a drink, some people love this famey thing. I can't stand it, but you've got to be nice to everybody. You've got to be bubbly, because everybody thinks I've got this larger-than-life character. I haven't all the time, and I get really bored with it all.
It wasn't just fame that Rowetta found difficult, but the legacy of a failed teenage marriage.
I'm a survivor, but it's really hard, and when people go, you're very strong, and probably not really. But I come across as very strong, that's good. I've been strong for my kids. I think if I hadn't got kids, I'd be dead or be completely fucked up.
To cope, Rowetta drinks up to 5 bottles of whiskey a week.
Whiskey is, for me, really, really powerful because it makes me feel good, it makes me feel... It don't make me feel happy, it makes me feel good, though. It makes me feel powerful, and I think it's because I lost a lot of my power when I was 16. I need this inner strength, and it gives me that where no one can touch me.